Your own expression becomes available there when you unblock in the mind the mechanisms we have there when we play. One is this thing of judging or becoming very pessimistic, like I am playing in the solo, supposedly I play something and then something doesn't come very good. And then one starts thinking, this sucks, this is bad. There is people who is very negative in this context, or yeah, they play and then they start saying, this sucks, this is bad, this sounds bad, sounds bad. Oh, look how I did that. Just in the moment that they are playing. So what happens? It becomes worse, 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 worse. I have seen, on the other side, I have seen Paco making a mistake in a live show, which he hated it because he also hated then that when it came the phone recording and all that, like anything, because before it was more difficult, but many people were recording cassettes or something. And then make a mistake, Paco, there in the show live, and then he twisted this mistake in a way that it became a great thing. So you say, wait a moment, I just saw this, it was a mistake, and look now, but he's using this as a door for creativity. This is how much freedom you can get by studying improvisation. This is the cool thing to learn. In fact, he said it even helped him. So what to speak of us? And he said everyone should do it. He included flamenco playing, classical, of course flamenco playing, that is what he contributed with. This is the goal, actually. The goal of flamenco is not to be parroting eternally, like the Cevicas stuff and the old guys, or all the so-called modern people who play a mix of both techniques, all the style with the cross leg and with the negra guitar or anything. You know what I mean? This is no modern. What Paco de Lucía changed the flamenco forever. All what is influenced by him now, with the singers, you see modern chords and stuff there, because of Paco, because of this modernization there. And this influence is very strong. Now, you can find your own path and your own personality inside that line. That is also not that you are copying something. In fact, the interesting thing is that you will come out from this process of improvising, but the blocking mechanisms are there. And therefore, we have to learn the difference between practice and playing and improvisation. And when you practice improvisation, you go through things that you don't handle yet. To know what you don't handle yet, that's why I am the teacher there, because I can tell you very easily from which point you can take the material and make it yours. Actually, you will own the level of that level that you are doing with me in the Skype. We have 9 levels of this thing. Beginners 1, intermediate 1, beginners 1, beginners 2, 3, and then intermediate 1, 2, 3, and then advanced 1, 2, 3. So we have 9 ways to go with this rhythm thing, the approach of harmony, and how we learn where we are to discover our own mood and our own emotional content inside that comes out when we can unblock this tricky mind telling you that this is wrong, etc. Therefore, we record the homeworks. So when we play as we play, right? But some people think that they are practicing. They say, "I practice 5 hours a day." Yeah, but that's not practice. That is just playing stuff random there, and that is not upgrading their playing. I mean, so the matter of how to practice, this is a very intricate topic, and this you cannot do alone. Do it yourself and be confused forever, I said, because there is no way. It's like, look, this is like asking a person to do his own dental work and without a mirror. How you can do that? You cannot do it this way. It's not possible. Because to become expert at this, at how you will digest this thing, this requires another specialization, which is me as a teacher doing it. And then ideally you need another person from outside, because one is too much inside oneself and they cannot see things. Therefore, Paco liked this objective thing, so much so that sometimes he never listened an album after recording again, because he didn't have much liking to display. Because why? Because he was trying to always do better, and he when he listened something, he will imagine this thing could be much better. Right? A bit paranoidly in his case, that we don't do. That is dangerous, that I have to unlearn with Master Kenny Werner, and I will recommend this effortless mastery method, because this applies to any field of life, and of course to any style of music, and of course to our style. So this description, I will post the link about this. Is a very useful thing, and very valuable, and is the only teacher, Master Kenny Werner, who approached this topic once for all, and that is really factually helping players to overcome the sabotage of the mind.
Mira, yo lo que descubrí ahí en la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería. Cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música debería aprender, porque en la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.